Hello everyone and welcome. In today's video, I'm going to show you how to use TubeBuddy for YouTube. Now, over the past few months, there are moments where I've been really, really frustrated because I spent so much time creating videos and yet I did not get views. At that time, I could not work out what the problem was, but I discovered TubeBuddy and I'd like to share what I discovered with you today. And this could be a game changer for you if you create content on YouTube. Okay, so let me start off with an example. So here's a video that I created, Flywheel Hosting. Now, yes, you know, the production, I spent so much time on it. It was good. In fact, it was a series of videos. But look at the views. I'm only getting 80 views, right? This is very, very frustrating. Now, I know for some of you, you may say, well, at least you're getting 80, but not if you're used to getting thousands of views per video. Okay, so this is what really prompted me to share this with you. So you can see here that the title is good, but yet the views are very low. If we go on YouTube and search for Flywheel Hosting Dashboard Overview, yes, you know, it's exciting. You can see all those videos, they are mine, and you can see the icon that really distinguishes my videos from everybody else. But it doesn't mean that these videos are getting a lot of views. And this is the point of this video. So with TubeBuddy, you can do a lot of exciting stuff because you can go in and do some research and find out how popular a keyword is. So this comes with a strategy. So first of all, you need to start off by doing a brainstorm of your ideas of keywords that you're going to use. So let's say you want to start off and do a series of videos on lead generation. That's your main keyword. So that's the keyword you start off with. Okay. So it is very, very important to go ahead and do the brainstorm first. Don't go in and start creating the video because you're going to waste a lot of time. It's hit and miss. You don't even know if that video is going to perform well. But with TubeBuddy, you are definitely going to know if this video is going to perform very well. The next part of the strategy is to do what is known as keyword competitiveness. Okay, this is where you can determine if a keyword is worth creating a video for. You may find that a keyword has no competition, but very few people are searching for it. So why would you create a video like that? Well, that explains why I got, you know, the low views in my example that I showed you. So let's go ahead and let's take a look at how we can do this keyword research. So I have TubeBuddy already installed and you can see it right here on the top where we have this icon. So I'm just gonna click here and go to Tag Explorer. So here with Tag Explorer, what I need to do is to pick a keyword around the video that I'm going to create. So the video I'm going to create is, let's say I need to create something on online marketing, okay? So I'm gonna type in online marketing. And then I'm gonna click on explore. Right, so already, this is a bad keyword to go for. And here's why. If we come over here to competition, we can see it's very, very high. The search volume, yes, is great, but chances of you competing here on with this keyword, online marketing, is close to none. And in fact, TubeBuddy gives you an overall score of 21 and it tells you if it's good or bad. So you can see here that it is bad and this is an indication that this is a keyword that you need to stay away from. So what we could do here is we could explore some of these keywords and see what we can do here. So first, what I normally do is I come over here to auto-suggested and I can take a look here. Okay, online marketing for beginners. I would click this keyword here, go back to my summary and see if the competition is much better. And we can see it's still, okay, it's come to average, but still I wouldn't go for a keyword which has overall score of average. I prefer going to for keywords which have a score of good. And especially if you're starting off, you need to start low and then start building up your videos. Okay, so let's start. Let's try something different here. Internet marketing for beginners. See what happens here. So this is the process that you do until you find something that is easier for you to do. Now, this is even worse because now it's gone back to bad, 33 out of 100. Okay, so again, I think affiliate marketing will be quite competitive. So let's see what happens here. Again, it's bad. In fact, this is really bad because there's a lot of people creating videos around this. So you could play around with coming here to auto-suggested and see what's coming out of Google here. So this is a fully featured tool, and it does a very good job of giving you indications whether a keyword is good to use. Okay, so let's come over here and let's look for lead generation. Let's see what happens here. Okay, so we can see here, this is bad. 39 out of 100. So this is where now you need to be a bit creative. So lead generation is almost similar to building an audience, right? So let's start off by, in fact, I'm just jumping a few steps ahead because I've already done the research and I've noticed that the keyword lead generation is very, very highly competitive. So let me give you a keyword that is much easier to rank for. So I'm going to type in here, building your audience. Okay, so let's explore this one. Right, so now you can see that things are getting better. We can see the search volume is really high. So that means people are searching for the keyword building your audience, and also the competition is high, but the overall competition is good and it has a score of 60 out of 100. So instead of trying to go for a keyword which is lead generation, you're much better off going for building your audience. Because those things are very similar and they get the same results. So this is the strategy that I now use to create my videos. So first of all, let's recap. Brainstorm your ideas. So brainstorming your ideas is very important. Some YouTubers, they just go out there and just start creating videos. Yes, that works if you have a large audience already. But for those of us that are trying to build our audience, it's quite tricky because you need to create videos that people are searching for. So that research is very, very important. The next step in this strategy is to do keyword competitiveness analysis. Okay, this is very important because you could choose a keyword that is very, very competitive, whereby it's very, very, very hard for you to rank. And also you could choose a keyword which is very, very low on competition, but no one is searching for it. So TubeBuddy gives you an indication of which videos you should go for by looking at the keyword score. So here the search volume is very high, which is a good thing. And the competition is not very high, which gives us an overall score of 60 out of 100. Okay, thanks a lot for watching. If you'd like to use TubeBuddy for your videos, I would appreciate it if you buy it through my affiliate link. By doing that, I get a little commission. So thanks in advance if you're going to be buying TubeBuddy through my affiliate link, which I've linked in the show notes below. Thanks a lot for watching and see you in the next one.